Hey guys, it's week three of the Banjo Hangout, Sullivan Banjo Company, custom banjo build. And the votes were counted on the wood rims, and it looks like we're going to choose the Sullivan Historic Factory Floor Rim. I'm partial to it, it's a good choice. We've got a walnut banjo with a factory floor rim, so those two components are done. We're on the tone rings now. I know really nobody really has an opinion on tone rings, but I'm still going to give you some choices. Our first weapon of choice here is an arch top tone ring. This one here is about 40 holes, but you can have it with or without holes. And really any of the tone rings that we talked about today can be plated in either nickel, gold, old nickel, or left unplated, but we're going to choose plating later. So we're just going to talk about rings today. But we have an arch top. The next choice that we have is one of the standard flatheads. It's our part number one. It's our Sullivan flathead that we've had out for almost 30 years now. We can have that with or without holes, and that is a short skirt tone ring. We can also do the Tennessee 20 tone ring with or without holes, and this one will be short skirt, and we can have the either this one or the other ones cryogenically treated. And then our last choice will be our newest tone ring. This is our experimental flathead tone ring. We're basing this right off our 1935 Gibson flathead. We've had 3 years of development, $300,000, and about 300 tone rings in the development of this tone ring. This is a long skirt tone ring that's based right off of our pre-war flathead. It's been computer measured. It's getting ready to go for an MRI. I mean, this one is as close as we've ever been. It's a really good ring. We've got a couple samples that we'll have out at IBMA, but the choice is yours. Remember, we're just choosing tone rings this week. We'll talk about the plating later. Thanks.